Hi, I'm Charcy Curtis, and this is the I'm for God Movement podcast. Guess what, y'all? This is episode 13, and I want to thank everyone that's been tuning in and watching us. And because of that, guess what? We will have a second season, so make sure you tune in. For those that's just tuning in, you have to go back and recap the other podcasts because you don't want to miss it. It's a lot going on, and all we're trying to do is help one another because there's somebody on here that you definitely can relate to. So, but today I have a special guest with me, Linnell. This is not only a customer of mine, but this is someone that's a good dear friend of mine. But I want her to introduce herself. Linnell, can you please tell the people a little bit about yourself and what you do?
Yes, my name is Linnell Sparrow. I am a makeup artist. I just love doing makeup and encouraging people. That's what I do.
How long you been doing makeup now?
For about 10 years.
Yes, yes. We had grew a relationship, me doing yes. your hair. And God has a way of just turning things one way. You came in for a service, but I got a service too because she has been nothing but a blessing. And I mean, I have to actually say, you know, even just thinking back on, you know, things you told me that God told you to say and how they came to pass, and you know, mean a whole lot when people don't realize, you know, you got to be able to receive things from people. Mm-hmm. And, you know, God has his way of putting people in position or whatever. But today, you know, is more or less about, you know, talking about just things in general, like how, of course, when we met, you know, how what brought you to me as a stylist or whatever.
I moved to the area. Someone asked me earlier what brought me here, and I was thinking to myself, oh, wow, actually the force of the Lord just really brought me here. Mm-hmm. And in the process of me coming here, mm-hmm. I was looking for a hairstylist. I mm-hmm. was doing makeup. Mm-hmm. And there were two young ladies that were in the mall that walked past me, and I was doing makeup, and I stopped them in their tracks, mm-hmm. asked them, who did your hair? Mm-hmm. And they were like, Chelsea Curtis does it at mm-hmm. salon. I was like, okay. Mm-hmm. The second lady, she said the same thing. And then mm-hmm. I was in Walmart, mm-hmm. and from like five lanes over, mm-hmm. now I wear glasses. I seen this lady hair, and I was like, oh my gosh, she looks amazing. Mm-hmm. And so I walked over and I asked her, I said, who did your hair? And mm-hmm. she said, Chelsea Curtis. And I mm-hmm. said, you know what? I got to find Chelsea. She said, no problem. I'll give you her number. And I called, made an appointment, and here we are.
Hey, listen, I even remember, you know, like I said, God has his way. You know, I remember the time when I'm for God came about.
Yes.
And how you was telling me, you know, Charcy, you know, God is going to use you with this brand. I was like, girl, bye. Not me. No, ma'am. What made you feel that way, that, you know, powerful? I mean, to tell me that.
It's the Holy Spirit deep in me that mm-hmm. lets me know. A lot of times when God speaks to you, mm-hmm. he's already placed it in you.
Yes.
He used other people to confirm it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So we can feel confident about mm-hmm. the things he's given us.
Right.
And so when you said it, I mean, I could see it. Mm-hmm. I could see it being used not necessarily as a tool to blow you up, mm-hmm. but as a tool to help you get closer to God, mm-hmm. to draw other people closer to mm-hmm. God. And it's just an entire movement of doing what we're supposed to do, which is to share who God is mm-hmm. so that people can know that you don't have to live the way that you live and you can have peace and joy in Christ.
Mm-hmm. And what do you say to people when you think about the, by looking back, it's been what, 7 years
yes.
maybe?
Wow.
And right, and how I was told you, girl, bye. God ain't going to use me with this brand. Like, what do you say about it? Because you know I was like,
yeah.
not me.
I think it's everything that I thought God was going to do, mm-hmm. and then I think there's so much more to come.
Oh yeah
you know
yeah.
I look at how humble mm-hmm. you've been through the entire process.
I receive it now, y'all. Let me tell y'all, I receive it now, okay? But at that time, she'll tell you, I was like, wrong person, maybe you, he not gonna use me, okay? This is gonna be a billboard for my clients because we had X line on the back.
Yep.
I forgot
and
on the front.
Everywhere I went, people were asking me, where did you get that shirt mm-hmm. from? I want to get one. Is that salon here? Mm-hmm. I want one of those. But I really look back and I see that how God has grown it and
oh,
how
yeah.
big
yeah.
Yeah. and how it has changed lives. And mm-hmm. it's just been amazing to watch it,
yeah.
knowing how it started
right.
and just stand back and looking. It's been so amazing.
Yeah. Even tell the people about the time where I know a customer of mine called me one day, right? And she says, Charcy, you got somebody on the side of the road holding a billboard to my IM4GOD. I was like, no. And she was like, girl, I turned around. It must have been an angel. Because I turned back around, they were gone. I was like, and I remember I was telling you about it. I was like, somebody holding the sign. You was like, oh, I forgot to tell you because God just told me to be obedient. And can you tell the people what made you do that? Y'all, that was her doing that. You know, sign road, IM4GOD. By herself, I ain't tell her to do it.
She didn't. She did not. But, you know, I have to be really honest.
Mm-hmm, yeah, please.
Sometimes God will put you in a position to humble you.
Oh, yeah.
And there have been things that God has allowed me to do. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and I don't share it all the time, right. But in my mind, I'm like, yeah, God, we did that, you know. And he's like, wait a minute, hold on. Slow down. Yeah. I need you to slow down. So he'll say things to me like going out holding his sign. It's like, you know what? Mm-hmm. You know what? We did do that. Now, this is what I need you to do today. Mm-hmm. I need you to go to that corner, mm-hmm, and stand there and hold this sign for 1 hour. And I was like, you said what? You want me to go and stand on this sign? Mm-hmm. And so many thoughts went through my head. Mm-hmm. I went through an embarrassment, mm-hmm, feeling, mm-hmm, and then I went through a prideful feeling. That's, mm-hmm, amazing how you can transition that quick.
Right.
And in the embarrassment feeling, I felt unworthy to stand there and hold that sign up.
Yeah.
Because that means I was going to be held accountable to what was written on, right, the sign.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a very busy road there. Right. All kinds of people travel that road.
Right.
And so, and I work in a public place.
Right.
And so then I begin to think, oh my God, people are going to see me out here. Mm-hmm. Oh my God, they're going to see me holding this sign. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be accountable for what I'm holding.
Oh, yeah.
And so that was one side of it. And then the prideful side is, oh my God, I don't want these people looking at me. God, then I'm going to have to answer questions. I don't want to do this. And after getting through all of that, mm-hmm, I said, you know what? Even though I went through so much craziness, the bottom line is, yes, Lord, I'll do it.
Yes.
And so Isaac, my son, he said, Mom, what are you doing with that sign?
Mm-hmm.
And I said, I'm going to go out and hold the sign. Mm-hmm. And he said, well, I'll go with you. I'm going to wear my IM4GOD shirt and I'm going with you. You know, he was about 7 years old at the time. Mm-hmm. And he held that sign with
proud,
so much joy and waving to the people.
Mm-hmm.
And people were so amazed. They blew their horns. Mm-hmm. They stopped to tell us that it was encouraging to see, mm-hmm, and that they needed that, mm-hmm, that day. And, mm-hmm, you know, it's amazing how a message, just, you know, simple as that, can help bring joy to someone's life, and you didn't even say a word to them,
right?
But it's the message that got through to them.
Yes, and it did just that, because like I said, she called me all excited, was like, we made it, you guys. I was like, no, I didn't do that. I was just talking to you. You was like, yeah, I was just being obedient. I wasn't supposed to tell you. And I was like, God, you know, you just come with all these surprises, you know what I'm saying? It never surprises me, you know what I'm saying? Because I just go with the flow. Like you said, just go with the flow. And I remember even that time whenever I had it, of course, we don't call the names. I had an episode with a first lady.
Mm-hmm.
And you had spoke to me. You told me that God was going to use me.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And you said, if she keeps coming, mm-hmm, you know, God going to give you something to tell her. And it's up to her to receive
it. Yes.
If she don't come back, she don't want to receive what God got for you.
Yes.
And that was so powerful because she came to me only two more times a little. I was like, oh, I guess she didn't want to hear that message. But, you know, it's funny how God, even that episode, he took me through a journey.
Yeah.
And I was like going through this whole thing like, you know what? I don't want to hear this. I don't want to hear that. And You know what I'm saying?
And
it's bigger than me. You know what I'm saying? I was like, you know, I had to get to a point and I was like, you know, I'm going to pray for her.
Mm-hmm,
you know what I'm saying? Because the flesh side was like, oh, God ain't done with me yet. So I'm about to curse you out. You know what I'm saying? But that side of him was like, no, you working for me.
Mm-hmm.
And because you're working for me, this, mm-hmm, is what I want you to do. Because you're going to show the God in you.
Yes.
Just because she ain't showing the God in her,
right,
you're going to show the God in her. And I was like, but that's not fair. I want to, you know. And then you had, it was, like I said, God puts people in a position that, you know, far as to help you humble, like you said.
He
knew I would receive it from you. Because he knows, like, God know, I'm a person. You go pray to God about a situation. And let him handle me. I'm not the one approach because, like I said, he ain't done me yet.
That's what all of this is about. Because when you were saying it, I was thinking to myself back then, I was so afraid, y'all, to tell her. I would be like, Lord, I need you to humble Chelsea because, you know, she's going to do my hair and I don't want her mad with my hair. So please, God, because I don't want to tell her. And you know what? God would always drop something in Chelsea's spirit and she would say it. Mm-hmm. And I would be like, you know what, Chelsea? I was just thinking about that.
Mm-hmm.
It was like a segue in for me to say what I had to say.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
But God working on me. I gotta say, I'm doing a lot better.
You are. We all are. Yeah. We growing.
You know, it's just funny how I have to think back to it. Even, you know how the devil busy, how, you know, like I said, we don't call him. Somebody tried to mess up our relationship. You know, mm-hmm. It was a business that you had previous, way before we met.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and I was right. And I was like, wrong person, wrong time. Mm-hmm. What he's like, mm-hmm. You told me the situation. And I was like, you know what, God, devil, that ain't gonna work.
And you know what? You also have to be honest, because I was honest with
you.
Yeah,
you were. Like, yeah, you really was. Yeah, you did. I was like, okay.
I did
it. But at the same, it had nothing to do with me. And mm-hmm. I was like, you know what? At the end of the day, you can't do no but respect, honestly.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And you had your reasons. And it was none of my business. But I was like, this didn't make sense. You know what I'm saying? Because we all have passes. Mm-hmm. If people don't tell the whole story, it's two sides mm-hmm. to everything.
Everybody want to present themselves as being good.
Oh, yeah.
And we're not always good. Mm-hmm. You know, it's Christ mm-hmm. that makes us good. Mm-hmm. But the only way we can have clean, it's important to have clean hands and a pure heart.
Right.
And the only way you can have that is just by being honest.
Yeah, yeah.
Trying to cover up and tell half the story mm-hmm. is going to come out.
Oh, yeah.
So
definitely.
Just tell the truth.
Yeah. You might as well, by the time they get it, like, I already know that. Mm-hmm. You know, they can't.
And that's how
that.
The devil gets you.
Yeah.
The devil gets you with your truth.
Oh, yeah.
And like, you know you did that. Now you can't even say anything.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
I can. I overcome by the word of my testimony. Yeah. I did that.
Yes.
But this is where God brought me today.
Yes.
You know, so
yes.
just being
yes.
honest
yes.
where we are.
Yes. And y'all, this is, like I said, she's more than just a friend. She was there when my brother passed away. She stood by my mom at that time. Mm. Of course, God was dealing with me. I had asked God previous, you know, like, God, you know, you have to condition me, fill me with all of you, and numb me. Mm-hmm. And not realizing, when you ask God to numb you, he do just that. Mm-hmm. So I was around, walk the funeral, just walking around, smiling. He in heaven. She was over there consoling my mom while I'm up here telling everybody, you know, where, because I mean, I was in peace, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And I knew where he, to me, even to this day, I don't feel like my brother's passed. I just feel like he's moved away. You know what I'm saying? I feel like I'm gonna see him again. And people are like, how do you deal with that? And I'm like, that's because I asked God for that numbness. I asked him to fill me up with him.
Yes.
So when you really do that and you mean it, he do just that. So I don't look at it as I won't see him again, because I will see him. I'm going to heaven.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying?
So
and with that being said, I thank you for that. You know, I never got a chance to tell you. I really thank you for that. And, you know, I just, you know, words cannot never explain how much you mean to me and my family.
Don't make me cry on the
whatever.
Show.
You was okay. Because, I mean, we talk about God all the time.
Yeah.
It's like, that's like the number one thing, you know. And like I said before, tell people, what was that first time you realized God was real?
The first time I realized God was real, honestly, I was a child.
Mm-hmm.
I had, out of the blue, developed epilepsy.
Mm-hmm.
And I was in a hospital in Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
And I went to the hospital in Virginia. Mm-hmm. And my mother, she had just given her life to the Lord
mm-hmm.
about 4 or 5 years prior to. And she was worn out. My father at the time had, he was a scientist,
mm-hmm.
and they was working on a project, and all of the scientists, mm-hmm. now we know, had developed asbestos, but had asbestos poisoning,
mm-hmm.
and had developed brain damage.
Mm-hmm.
And so he was off.
Mm-hmm.
We was dealing with different types of mental illnesses at that time, and then she has a child
mm-hmm.
that is randomly mm-hmm. Going through epileptic episodes.
Mm-hmm.
And so, she mm-hmm. took me to church. I would never forget it. Can I call out this church?
You can.
Okay. Because I haven't been to that church mm-hmm. since then, but
mm-hmm.
I remember these ladies, and I had to be about 9 years old.
Mm-hmm.
It was First Baptist West Monday in Chesapeake, Virginia. There
mm-hmm.
were a group of ladies. I don't know their name,
mm-hmm.
but they was hosting a revival at the church I attended,
mm-hmm.
and my mother was so tired, she took me to the altar, and she said, now, I have not seen this happened,
right.
but I have read about it, and
mm-hmm.
I believe in the Bible,
right.
and I believe God is going to heal you.
Mm-hmm.
And they prayed for me,
mm-hmm.
and I didn't feel anything,
mm-hmm.
but when I left, I believed.
Oh, yeah.
And I have not had an epileptic episode since.
Mm-hmm.
And so that taught me that God is a healer.
Oh, yes.
And so I would begin to talk to God,
mm-hmm.
you know, and in my room by myself, I would talk to the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And my mother encouraged me to read. And that alone, knowing that God was a healer, is a healer,
oh, yeah.
has taken my relationship with him
mm-hmm.
and grown it.
Mm-hmm.
And I've taught that to my children. So
mm-hmm.
that was my first connection with
mm-hmm.
God, because you know you hear about God
oh, yeah,
but until
yeah.
you get your own personal
yeah, you, tell me about
you know
it.
Relationship
yeah.
That was my first connection. Mm-hmm. I was 9 years old.
Yeah, yeah, because that's what I tell people all the time. Like, when you get your own relationship, it's totally different. You know, people could tell you all different stories, but it's nothing like your own. Yes. You know what I'm saying? So once you get, and that's why, like I said, even with the I'm for God movement, all it is saying, you know, get your own relationship with God and then let him handle the rest. And, you know, even far as, you know, what is there something that you would like to, you know, tell the, because people, you know how they try to prejudge you.
Yes.
They
yes.
look at you and they're like, oh, ain't nothing wrong with her. She had it all, da 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 da. You know what I'm saying? And then you sit there and say, you don't know my story.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? God uses whoever
That's
he
true.
Wants
yes.
you.
Yes. Whoever he wants
yes.
to use.
I mean, is it anything you would like to share with people as far as, you know, to let them, encourage them, to let them know that, you know, God is doing what he said he's going to do, regardless of whether you want to do it or not. But something you encourage, you'd like to tell the people?
Yeah, I just want to encourage people, no matter what walk of life you are in, mm-hmm. you know, first of all, be open to God using anyone in your life. Mm-hmm. I've had from homeless people who are intentionally homeless. They have decided to be homeless, mm-hmm. Doing whatever they do, whether it's they do drugs or alcohol, whatever the case may be. I have had God use people of that such to mm-hmm. minister to me. And I know it was God mm-hmm. speaking through them at that moment. You know, be open to receive the word of God, not mess, but the word of God. Mm-hmm. And then think about it. If God can use anybody, mm-hmm. he can use you no matter what state that you're in.
Oh, yeah.
You know, because when God really came to me for me to be serious about him, mm-hmm. you know, I was smoking weed, drinking, having my best life, mm-hmm. you know, and what I thought was my best yeah. life. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the Holy Spirit spoke to me while I was high. And mm-hmm. I was like, I can't believe I have to, something is wrong.
Right.
Just blew my mind, mm-hmm. you know, and he let me know, mm-hmm. no, I need you to understand, mm-hmm. you know me and I need you to change your life. Mm-hmm. So God can meet you wherever
Ever.
You are.
Yeah, that is so
and
true.
We have to be careful not to judge people mm-hmm. in whatever state they in. Mm-hmm. You may see someone that's praising the Lord in church, you don't know why they're praising the
yeah,
Lord.
Right.
That may not be a sign of they so holy. Yeah. That may be a sign of they so sinful. That and I made it today.
Right. You better know it.
You know? Mm-hmm. So just being aware that God accepts us for who we are. Mm-hmm. We just have to be willing to be honest in who we are. Mm-hmm. And once we are honest in who we are, commit to say, Lord, I mm-hmm. want to serve you. Mm-hmm. I want to represent you. Mm-hmm. And that's going to come with change. You know, we yeah. have to change.
And people think too, like, you know, because you have this walk with God, that you don't go through things and
oh,
you don't
no,
go through things with
do.
Your kids. And mm-hmm. I'd be like, the devil can attack you more mm-hmm. when you walking with God, because he's mm-hmm. going to attack you through your kids. He's going to do it. And you have to get to that point, you know, regardless of the fact you're going through.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as long as you know you're going through and it's not going to
yes.
last forever, you'll be okay.
Yes.
You know, and I just want to thank you so
thank
much.
You.
And I'm going to have to get you back on here, because y'all, oh. I will be having a girls' day at this I'm for God movement. And we're going to have girls' day. And we're going to just talk and chat and let people know, you know, how, about ourselves
yes,
or whatever,
yes.
just to help. It's not, like I said, it's about helping one another.
That sounds good.
And y'all, guess what? I want y'all to tune in and definitely check out that website. I do have it ready for y'all, the I'mforgod.com. The number four, not the word. And y'all check it out and stay tuned for season 2. You don't want to miss it. Thank you again.